Hey, please.
Faster!
Yeah, babe, I'm gonna handcuff you.
Ladies.
Get out of my face!
Oh my God!
You are a cheater.
Now you're a comedian.
Real reality television is brought to you by Cheaters Detective Agency's Private Eyes on Cheaters.
Alarmed by his live-in boyfriend's lack of affection, Sebastian Asner is starting to believe there's something sinister behind his cold demeanor. Needing answers instead of deception, Sebastian wants to bring the truth to light. I'm Joey Greco. And this is Cheaters.
When I met Brian, I was visiting from Louisville, Kentucky during a summer break with some friends. We were out of the club and I saw him, he saw me, and we started talking. He begged me for like a year and a half to move down here. And I finally decided I wanted to change the scenery. So I came down here, and about a year ago when we actually finally did move in together, I started noticing that he just started acting real distant and shady. He put a different lock code on his phone, and I don't know, he's just real secretive and acting kind of funny. When he came home from work one night, he was like getting ready to take a shower or whatever, and he took his shirt off. And it's a polo shirt, so it has a collar on it, so it's kind of hiding it. But when he took his shirt off, I noticed that he had all these marks on his neck. So I asked him, what is that? And he was like, those are hickeys. And I was like, how'd they get there? And he told me that I put them there. And I was like, really? Like, that's impossible. There's no way I could have done that. Because for one, I don't leave hickeys. And for two, like, we haven't been intimate in, you know, I don't even know how long. If I was to catch Brian cheating on me, I guess I honestly don't know what I'd do, but I'd probably go crazy.
If you suspect infidelity in your relationship, Cheaters Detective Agency may be able to provide you assistance. Exercise your right to be informed. Investigative charges may apply. Brian, age 24. A clerk suspected of giving out his sweet treats to another man. Investigation Day 2. After assembling all necessary intel on the suspect, Cheaters agents surround his place of employment and begin surveillance. Around lunchtime, perimeter units spot the suspect, identified only as Brian, exiting the shopping mall and waiting by the curb. A few minutes later, an approaching automobile draws detectives' attention. The car pulls up to a stop in front of Brian. He enters the passenger seat and gives the mysterious driver a brief kiss. Mobile units initiate pursuit and follow the pair to a nearby fast food restaurant. Brian and his unknown male companion exit the vehicle and walk across the lot. They enter and order. Brian laughs with his host as they sit across from one another, gorging themselves on a couple of supersized combo meals. The energetic lunch comes to an end, and the couple leave. Mobile units follow the couple back to the shopping mall and spy the two engaging in a long goodbye kiss. Brian eventually steps out of the car and goes back to work. Investigation Day 3. Ground agents take advantage of the crowds and venture into the mall. Nearing the end of his shift, Brian is visited by his companion from earlier surveillance, whose identity remains withheld. Detectives keep eyes on the duo as they walk through the mall and into an elevator. The detective secretly scopes out the suspect and his clandestine companion on the ride up and out of the mall. Once in the parking lot, Brian is escorted to his partner's car. Mobile units pull behind the dark sedan as it enters a nearby parking garage. The car climbs to the third floor before finding a parking space. Once the engine is cut off, the activity inside the cab revs up. Once the couple's passion subsides, they emerge from the car and share another fervent moment saying goodbye. The companion watches longingly as Brian returns to his car and departs. Investigation Day 6. Brian appears to be in the middle of an important phone call while he makes his way across the parking lot and into his vehicle. Brian finds his way to a desolate and darkly lit parking lot. He backs his vehicle into a space, seemingly signaling his companion already waiting to get in. As Brian enjoys his surreptitious affections, it's Sebastian who's affected in this recorded phone call. With all the evidence pointing to an affair, agents pull up stakes and return to headquarters to begin analyzing the data for Sebastian's review. Coming up, the confrontation.
With evidence of his boyfriend's patent dishonesty, Cheaters brings Sebastian the proof. Ready for his agony to end, he sets his sights on forgiveness until he sees the truth.
Well, Sebastian, I know that you've been concerned for quite a while. I know you've had some questions and some difficulty understanding what's actually going on in your relationship with Brian.
Right.
Our detectives have information that they thought it was very important that you see. I know you're apprehensive, but are you ready to view that now?
Hell yeah.
On this afternoon, we had a detective outside of the shopping mall where Brian works. Brian exits the building and was observed having a phone conversation. Not too many more minutes after that, and a car pulls up. As he gets in, he leans in and appears to give this individual a kiss. They're followed to a fast food restaurant, and now that we see, as they enter, that this is another gentleman. They have a meal, return back to Brian's place of employment. There is another prolonged exchange, and then Brian goes inside and goes back to work. On this afternoon, our detective, from a higher vantage point, observed Brian at work. The same gentleman that we've seen him with previously approaches the counter. They have a conversation. Not long after that, they leave. Our detective was able to get inside the elevator and catch them in a casual exchange. But they were followed out until they get to the vehicle of this other gentleman. It looks like they're beginning to leave the parking area, but they veer off and actually go into a covered area of the parking structure. They spend some time there, Sebastian, of a more intimate nature at that location. Before they get out, we see another romantic exchange. He gets into your car, and Brian returns home for the evening. On this day, we again observe Brian as he leaves work. Our detectives follow until he arrives at a park that's not too far away. Now, Brian backs in, is joined by his gentleman friend. They leave, go to a nearby convenience store, go inside, make some purchases. They go back to the park. They steal a few more intimate moments at the park. They start to leave, but this gentleman hasn't had quite enough. Goes back in to double dip, and then when they're each satisfied, they each go their separate ways.
Okay.
I'm going to go ahead and see if I can reach our detective for an update.
Okay. what's taking place right now. Hey, we just finished up with a briefing. We're in the vans and we're rolling in your direction. Okay. He just left them all. His friend was there waiting for each other. They're both driving. Detectives behind them.
Okay. Just thinking about the fact that he's in my car right now is just... Ugh.
Arkansas dead ends into a lake, and that's where they are. Okay, we're on our way right now.
Come on, Sebastian.
There's Gomez over here. Come on with me.
Ready? Let's do it. Let's go. Let's go.
Y'all,
move.
What the hell is this?
What's up, guys? Can I help you? Brian,
what's that?
What is this? Who the is that?
Who is that, actually?
What are you doing here?
What the are you doing here, actually?
Chilling. Why are you here?
Why else would I be here? What the do you think?
I'm not talking to this.
Bitch, move.
No, I'm not going to talk to you.
Bitch, this. Move. What's up?
Can you get the camera out of my face, dude?
Why are you here? This is unnecessary. What the f*** is all this bullshit?
Oh my god.
Coming up next, the conclusion.
Arkansas dead ends into a lake, and that's where they are.
What the hell is this?
Who the f*** is that?
Who the f*** is that?
Why are you here?
Oh my god. Watch out.
This is his boyfriend. They live together.
Okay.
The truck that Brian drives around in.
Don't need to know.
Bastion's.
You a lying ass mother.
So?
Nothing ass mother. Bitch, get your hands up. Bitch.
What is your problem?
You, bitch.
Well, you guys, easy. Gentlemen. Gentlemen, calm down. So he's been lying as much as he's been lying to his boyfriend.
I don't know nothing about this bitch right here.
Okay, well, so, you would, because he's been lying, and that's my point.
Man, I don't got nothing to say to y'all right now. You ready?
Let's go. Mm-hmm.
Why are you trying to leave, bitch? I need my keys.
I'll give them to you later.
No, give me my keys right now.
Keys.
Why I ain't gonna get in this little raggedy ass car with you, bitch?
Okay.
Give me my keys.
Go
house. You. Get the f*** out the damn way. Come on.
You are so...
Move, bitch. Why you up my face, bitch?
Hey. Hey.
Careful.
Go home. I gave you your keys. Take your ass
home.
Where
the f*** are they? Bitch,
over there.
Don't tell me to go home. You don't
go
know
home.
Me, bitch.
Right. Come on. Get the f*** out of my way, bitch.
Hey. No, that's not necessary. Let's calm this down.
Brian, come on, man.
Get them apart.
Get your mouth. Come on.
Got your glasses, bitch.
We'll get some new ones, ho. Get the out the way.
Punk ass bitch. You a punk.
I told you to go away.
Bitch, we throw.
Gone.
We throw.
Duh. Obviously. Hickey, this one
cop's gonna be up here, man. Let's go.
So that's the motherfucker put them hickeys on your neck?
Obviously.
Because that didn't come from you. Come on, Brian. Why you talking to him? Why you talking to him?
Do you see what you're walking away with?
Yeah.
Not
look
you.
At you. You're right.
Bitch.
Move!
When you cheat, bitch, cheat up. Cheat up. Not down. You downgraded.
Get in, Brian.
You think that?
Don't come to my house, bitch.
Get in, just watch out.
Get the out the way! Bitch, go!
You bitch!
You okay? Watch out.
I'm so done with this.
That motherfucker
broke my seat. Imagine that. You all right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Just relaxing a little bit.
I'm cool.
Okay, all right.
Talk to Sebastian real quick. Sebastian, I'm gonna follow you home just to make sure everything's okay. Okay. So just drive slow, check your time. I know right now you've kind of gone through a whole lot real fast. I'm gonna follow you home and shoot you home. Okay, all right? So thank you.
Following the confrontation, Sebastian succumbs to his depression. Later, we'll update you on his condition. But next, we welcome back Dolly Bailey, a former client hoping to shed some light on her actions when confronting her boyfriend on Cheers.
When I walked in that bar, I just completely flipped. I have never been so angry in my entire life. I cannot believe that he was actually there. He was singing that song to her. I remember when he was writing that song, and he just kept telling me it was about a fictitious woman. It was didn't mean anything, and then to walk in there and to see her and realize that it was, and hear him singing that song to her. I cannot believe that he did that.
What are you doing, mother?
Yo.
Huh? What are you doing?
You gotta stop it.
You better stop it. Come here.
Get in there. I mean, this was a long-term 10-year relationship, you know, for him to do something like this. I mean, if he was so unhappy, why did he just not end it before then? Why did he have to do this? Why did he have to go there?
Ladies and gentlemen, Dolly, everybody.
Yeah, are you serious? Are you serious?
How long have you been seeing him?
Probably about 5 months now.
Do you know that they've been together for 10 years? Has he told you that?
Somebody told me they were done.
Why don't you tell him everything you've been doing? And my house, man, that I pay for.
I haven't been doing anything.
Car, they make pants on you.
He did try contacting me several times, trying to work it out after all this happened, but there was just absolutely no way. There's no way that I could even consider ever, you know. I have more respect for myself than that.
In the aftermath of the confrontation, Sebastian Asner is heartbroken that the man he gave his love to would do this to him. He claims that he has no one to turn to in his time of need and has become despondent over the past few weeks. With the help of Cheaters producers, Sebastian has finally agreed to counseling, but fears the hole in his heart will never heal. When finally reached by Cheaters producers, Brian was less than open. He would only say that Sebastian has a selective memory and wants nothing more to do with him. As for Brian's companion, he wants Sebastian to know that Brian is happy.
Hey, please.
Faster!
Yeah, babe, I'm going to handcuff you.
Ladies.
Get out of my face!
Oh, my God!
You are a cheater.
Now you're a comedian!
That's what you deserve. Real
reality television as brought to you by Cheaters Detective Agency's Private Eyes on Cheaters.
With serious concerns regarding her boyfriend's private time activities, Brittany Hotchkiss needs to know what secrets he's keeping. Distrusting of his actions when she's not around, Brittany commissions a comprehensive examination of her relationship. I'm Joey Greco. And this is Cheaters.
All of a sudden, it went from us like having this perfect relationship to me not being able to reach him and me not being able to get access into his things the way he would, you know, always give me access. It's just, it's different. It's like a totally different, and you know it, you know? I try to talk to him, and it's like now I can't even get through to him. Like, it used to be where I could have conversations with him, and we could really work things out. But now it's like I'm speaking, you know, a different language. He's speaking a different language, and there is, like, no mediation. There's nothing in the middle to help us communicate anymore. It's like a wall there. I feel like most of it is my fault. I feel like I've done something wrong. I feel like I can't make him happy anymore. And that I did make him happy for a while, and that it's something wrong with me. And I know that that may not be the case, but that's exactly how I feel. I feel like there's something wrong with me, that, you know, this relationship seems so perfect, and then all of a sudden he's completely turned off by me, or he's completely changing his patterns or his ways. It has to be something that I did. I can't sleep. I can't concentrate. Am I gonna be by myself tonight? In any day, is it going to end? Is it going to be over? I don't know.
If you suspect infidelity in your relationship, Cheaters Detective Agency may be able to provide you assistance. Exercise your right to be informed. Investigative charges may apply. Granville, age 35. A financial planner suspected of putting his profit in another woman's dividend. Investigation Day 3. After 2 days and no movement on the case, Cheaters detectives remain diligent outside the apartment the client and suspect share. An unknown female is spotted slinking up the stairs to the suspect's front door. The woman knocks, and the suspect, identified only as Granville, opens the door and steps out onto the porch. After a brief hug hello, Granville ushers his neighbor down the stairs and into the passenger seat of his car. Mobile units follow the pair across the street to a local bar. They walk arm in arm inside and are soon spotted by undercover agents enjoying some drinks at the bar. The couple appear to be in good spirits while imbibing some spirits of their own. Eventually, the two leave the establishment and return to Granville's residence. They both ascend the stairs and disappear inside the apartment. An hour and a half later, Granville sees his companion to the door. She returns to her own apartment, and Granville shuts the door, ending this day of investigation. Investigation Day 5. With Brittany again working the late shift at her restaurant job, agents are on high alert for further developments. They spot the suspect, shirtless, coming out onto the balcony with a phone. It's evident that his phone call was to beckon his downstairs neighbor upstairs. The neighbor, now identified only as Andy, appears dressed as if she just got out of the shower. Andy makes her way up to Granville and indicates to him that she wants something more than just a cup of sugar. Granville apparently likes what he sees and begins to grope Andy on the balcony. The two spend some time exhibiting their lust before retiring inside the apartment that Granville and Brittany share. A few hours tick by before agents regain sight of the couple. Andy exits the apartment but is not allowed to leave just yet. Granville grabs his busty beauty and delivers a few final kisses for the night. Investigation Day 8. It seems to detectives on duty that a pattern of deceit is forming. With Brittany working the late shift, they see Andy and Granville leaving their apartments almost in unison. The suspect scurries down the stairs to greet his buxom buddy by his car. Mobile units then track the couple to another nearby bar. They enter and are soon seen on the patio enjoying some beverages. It may be date night for Granville, but it's Brittany who's picking up the tab, as revealed in this recorded phone call. With a final nail in the proverbial coffin, PIs return to headquarters and begin compiling the bad news for Brittany. Coming up, the confrontation.
With proof of Granville's flagrant philandering, Brittany's brought in to inspect the findings. Unaware as to the depth of his degeneracy, she tries to find peace before the truth sets her free.
On this particular evening, while you were at work, a neighbor exits, goes upstairs, knocks on the door, there's a brief hug. A short time later, they exit the building. He lets her into the passenger side of his vehicle. He gets in his side. And after he gets in, they travel to a bar.
That's across the street from my house.
He gets the door. They go inside, grab a seat. They have some drinks, go back to the apartments. She goes inside. She's in there for a short period of time.
She shouldn't be in my house. She shouldn't be in my house.
She exits, goes down to her place. Granville goes inside. On this occasion, a little different scenario plays out. Granville's outside on the phone. The neighbor comes upstairs, sporting a robe, which she promptly opens up, exposes herself to Granville, evidently pleased. They go inside your apartment, and the light turns off. Quite some time later, the door opens up. You see a brief romantic exchange, and she goes downstairs to her apartment. We've had a detective stationed outside of your place again tonight, and we know that they're together.
Yeah, right now.
Right now. I'll tell you what, let's go ahead and get in the van. We'll call the detective from there and see if he can give us an update on their whereabouts. Okay? You ready? Come with me. Gomez, what do you have on your end? So they went to the same bar? To the same bar that they've been going to. Okay, they're in now? Got it.
No.
Okay.
No.
Well, we know where that is, and we're headed there right now. Meet you around back. All right. Go around back when we get there. Okay, on our way.
Follow me, bud. Go.
Touch me.
What are you talking?
You are a liar.
What am I lying about?
I'm gonna start moving it outside. What,
this, you know who the
save him,
baby, come here. Baby,
you already know, G. Don't play like that. You already know.
What are you talking about?
We already
about?
Know. First we've of had, all, we've had to you shut talk. The hell up. Ain't nobody f***ing you. Because you know better. You know better.
Ladies.
Get your ass. You know better.
Come on, get her off. Settle down.
You should have been taking care of your business. He wouldn't have to come over in the middle of the night.
Coming up next, the conclusion.
And we know that they're together.
What the f- going on? Oh, hell no. What the f-
Get her off of him.
Why are you tripping?
You already know. We don't do it like that. I know where the f- you live. I know where the f- you live, and I'm going to be all up in your bed, bitch.
Let me go.
Just
Get, no, get, protect her. Get her off him.
Babe, babe, babe.
Come on. Break it up. What I taste like, ho? What I taste like?
Don't touch my mother shoe. Don't touch that belong to me. None of y'all.
The car is in the front.
The car is
in the front. Let's go to the car in front.
Whoa, y'all cupcake.
I ain't did nothing.
Y'all cupcake.
We're not cupcaking.
They just show me the damn video, you
I ain't seen no video. Show me a video.
Here.
Somebody get
this
no
video. I got it right here.
What you gonna show me on video?
Okay.
Somebody
outside on your phone. Who's coming upstairs? Your neighbor. Remember that night?
Okay, we neighbors. She can't come to my house.
Oh, she can come to my house. In a bathroom.
Oh, yeah, you're
in a bathroom. You got your damn shirt off.
The problem is he doesn't remember. He don't already know because he forgot.
I don't drink that
here,
much.
How about this?
Okay, how about
obviously, you do got to drink a lot. Orangutan, you up in here with this
remember
bitch.
That? Remember that?
Okay, well,
now look,
fake ass, precious
you can do whatever you want, but if you're not happy with her,
so
why are you still keeping her in the relationship?
She already knows.
That's my girl.
That's your girl?
Then why are you standing next to her? If I'm your girl, you with me.
You out here tripping, you got all these people. This is where I come to hang out at, and you got all these people looking at me crazy.
This is where we hang out at. We're here every day together. You already know. I know, don't run, motherfucker. Don't run!
You ain't got your work clothes on.
Don't run!
Okay, come on, let's go. You ain't gonna keep embarrassing me.
No, we ain't been talking about.
Come on, let's go.
No. He ain't gonna talk about.
Badass security guard.
Let her go. Let her go.
I'm gonna be in jail after tonight.
No, look here.
No, we ain't finna talk about.
Get my keys.
Make sure somebody got the motherfucking money. If I'm gonna whoop this ass.
Stop.
Say something else. Dumb.
Where y'all?
Bitch.
That way y'all got security license.
Say something.
G, let's go. Come on, G.
Here, take the keys. Go get in the car.
I'll go
to the car.
Come on. In the front.
Let
that fat bitch walk.
Give her
we live
earrings.
Across the street.
It broke now.
No.
I guess you bought them earrings too, huh?
We live across the street.
Say,
let that fat bitch walk.
Why y'all
let
her walk up on me?
Huh?
Y'all let her walk?
Why you walking away? You scared?
Because
you scared, bitch? You scared? You scared? No. It's just the beginning. Please don't touch me.
Settle down.
No.
Get in the car, please.
She already knew.
Please don't worry.
Get in the car.
She already knew.
Come on.
I ain't about to romp in that hole.
Say something else.
But guess what? Who getting in the car?
Oh.
Who getting in the car?
That ragged ass Chrysler.
Who putting gas in it? You.
Bitch, I ain't putting no motherfucking gas in this ragged ass.
What?
Still
why
got
you in like this?
Hey,
still got case.
You set this in
or
motion.
What?
All right.
All
right, y'all want to play games?
Or
y'all
want to
play games? Get the away from my car.
Oh, what you going to do? Oh, you going
to.
You going to give.
Get in with my car.
You gonna get
physical?
Or what? Or what you gonna do? No. Cause I've been nice. You want me to act ignorant? You want me to be stupid like this
car.
Belligerent ass, ignorant ass fool?
Really? Ignorant got good. Ignorant.
You fat.
You
all girls got good. Stupid ass bitch.
I got your man.
I know you ain't talking. Look at that damn skeleton man over here. Oh, ugly ass, crackhead, survival looking ass mother.
Conditioning.
Yeah, you know how fat ass need air conditioning.
Let's go.
Get the car. Get out of my car.
Oh, no!
Let her go, man. Let her go.
No.
I don't get out of my car. Get out of
here. I pay insurance on this damn car. This is my damn car too. This is my car too. I don't have to get out. I don't have to get out of no mother. Car that got my name on it too.
Well, y'all better move the out of my way.
You gonna run like a little bitch? You gonna be scared? You scared? No, that's all right. Let him run away. No, that's all right, cause I got my house key right here. It's about to go.
Following the confrontation, Brittany attempts to rise above her fury to find a silver lining. At the end of the show, we'll inform you as to her success. But now, Desiree Furlong, the companion from the Melissa Fletcher case, reveals her thoughts on being exposed while on a bender by cheaters.
We're just getting our drink on, and then shortly after that, you know, got a little flirtatious because, you know, we're drunk, we're looking to have a good time. So then we pulled over into like a dark, you know, spot just to, you know, have sex. And then all of a sudden camera lights came on, and then he got pulled out of the car, and then I just really don't really remember what happened. Like I said, I was drunk.
Get your ass out of the car! What the are you doing?
What the
man? What is your problem?
Hey, okay, all right.
What are you
right.
doing?
Well, what's your deal, dude?
What is this? What is this?
She's just a friend.
Oh,
man.
She's just a friend?
What's going
what
on?
What do you mean,
man?
What's going on?
What's
you
going
get the
on?
Out of the way.
So a little bit after the show, yeah, we saw each other on and off for about 2 weeks after that, you know, but the fact that, you know, he cheated on his girl, that always plays in the back of mind, and I'm not really looking for anything serious. I'm just gonna keep trucking. He's not the one. Like I said, you know, it took me 2 weeks to find out. You know, I was just having fun then, it's nothing now, and it's just nothing, you know, nothing serious anymore. So
how much have you had to-
absolutely enough. He did not drink enough as what I drank.
Can you say that again? I'm sorry.
Great. He had not drank enough what I had drank. Is that good enough for you? Yeah, I'm looking for love one day, but obviously, you know, I'm just gonna have fun. I'm not gonna jump anything I know I'm not gonna be serious about, but I'm not gonna just be like some old nanny, you know, sitting in bed with myself, you know. So I'm just gonna go out and have my fun, and if love comes along, it does. If not, then I'm just gonna keep doing my thing.
Now that she's had time to collect herself, Brittany Hotchkiss has concluded that it's time to move on and away from Granville's lies. Regarding her former friend and neighbor, she says, let her have him. Cook him up and eat him for all I care. She needs less fat in her diet anyway. Brittany is currently living with her cousin until she finds a permanent residence. Granville continued to profess his innocence, claiming that all the footage obtained by detectives did not tell the whole story. He states, you need to get your facts straight before you go on ruining people's lives. Andy didn't return.
Hey, please.
Faster!
Yeah, man, we don't handcuff you.
Ladies.
Get out of my face!
Oh my God!
You are a cheater!
Now you're a comedian!
That's what you deserve.
Real reality television, as brought to you by Cheaters Detective Agency's Private Eyes on Cheaters.
After a whirlwind romance that celebrated a marriage and child, Thelma Gosling now finds time to catch her breath. Unexplained disappearances and a cold bed, however, lead her to believe that her marriage may be built on treacherous ground. I'm Joey Greco, and this is Cheaters.
The day that I found out I was pregnant, he was in shock when I told him, but he said he was going to do the right thing. He was going to marry me, and it would be a happy family. He started acting different probably about a month after we were married. He wouldn't call like he said he would. Used to, he would tell me every detail, everything to, I'm going to the store, it'll take me 30 minutes, I'll be back, to now it's, he'll just leave the house and I won't know where he's going or what he's doing. The other day, I went to his truck and I was getting the diaper bag out of his truck and there was a Budweiser can in there, and he doesn't drink Budweiser, and he drinks Bud Light in the bottle. I mean, that's his drink. And so it made me suspicious, wondering, why is that kind of beer in there? Who's been with him? I feel he needs to be a good role model for our son. We've only been married 3 months. In that 3 months, I need to know this is for real. I need him to be there for us instead of me having to worry at night that where he's at or what he's doing. If he gets hurt, you know, is our son not gonna have a father?
If you suspect infidelity in your relationship, Cheaters Detective Agency may be able to provide you assistance. Exercise your right to be informed. Investigative charges may apply. Brendan Gosling, age 36, a salesman suspected of freely feeding his desire for other women. Investigation Day 2. Using information provided by Thelma, Cheaters field agents catch the suspect leaving work a little early. The suspect finally arrives at a medical center and exits his pickup truck. The suspect, Brandon Gosling, strides to the entryway but pauses before entering. Agents spot an unknown vehicle and Gosling moves toward the SUV. He opens the driver's door and escorts an unknown female from the cab. The two share a kiss while walking arm in arm into the facility. An additional mobile unit picks up the pair exiting a short time later. While agents ponder the nature of the visit, Gosling sends his companion off with a kiss. He then returns home for the remainder of the evening. Investigation Day 5. Perimeter units inform their mobile counterparts of Gosling's departure from the family home. Mobile 2 reacquires Gosling, arriving at a large, unknown ranch. He parks and promptly disappears from agents' view. Investigators dispatch a ground agent in the hopes of resuming visual contact. Gosling is soon identified in the horse corral, grooming one of the mares. Before long, a familiar face is detected walking toward Gosling. The woman from previous surveillance, now identified as Cassie Potts, offers her hard-working stud a beer. Gosling eagerly accepts the cold brew and takes a long, slow swig. If any doubt still lingers as to the nature of Gosling's relationship with Potts, those doubts are put to rest as the couple share a long and loving kiss across the stable gate. Potts playfully advises her rough rider to get back to work, handing him the grooming brush before trotting off and into the house. Agents lose sight of the suspect once he follows suit. Sometime later, mobile units watch as the suspect's vehicle pulls out of the gravel driveway and heads home for what's left of the evening. Investigation Day 7. Under the cover of darkness, mobile units follow suspect Gosling as he drives down familiar roads, but not the ones that lead to home. He arrives at the ranch house from previous surveillance and is greeted by a smiling Potts. They walk arm in arm back to the truck and speed off. Agents keep up with the couple, finally pulling up to a honky-tonk. They enter the establishment and settle by the pool tables near the back. While the cowboy bootleggers play their game, it's Thelma who's behind the eight ball, as evidenced by this recorded phone call.
Hey, hon.
Hey, baby, how are you?
I'm good. Where are you at?
Oh, I'm hanging out with a friend.
Oh.
Well, I'm gonna hang out with them for a while.
How long?
For a while. It's an old friend that you don't know.
Well, okay. Well, when are you gonna be home?
Later. But I'll call you before.
Okay. Love you.
Love you, too.
Once back at the ranch, Gosling and Potts enjoy a nightcap on the back porch. With more than enough evidence, agents pull back and return to headquarters to begin compiling Thelma's dossier. Coming up, the confrontation.
With substantial evidence of an ongoing affair, Thelma is brought proof of her concerns. Distraught by the unknown, she prepares to observe her husband's dark secret.
Thelma, our detectives do have information that may shed light onto the things that you've been seeing and experiencing around your home and in your relationship with your husband. Are you prepared to look at that now?
Yes.
On this day of our investigation, we followed Brandon as he left work. Now, he was followed until he pulled into the parking lot of a physician. Now, he waits there for a short period of time until a car pulls up alongside. A young lady gets out, and they greet each other with a hug. Now they go inside the physician's office, and after some time, they exit, and they go their separate ways. On this evening, we follow Brandon as he leaves work. Our detectives followed him as he went back to the ranch house where we have seen him previously. Goes up to the front door, knocks, the same young lady that we've seen him with previously, opens the door, lets him in. They're there for a short period of time before exiting, and they're followed to a local bar. They're engaged in a game of billiards, and after pocketing some of his balls, he is rewarded with a passionate show of affection. Later that evening, they drive back to the ranch, but once they arrived back at the ranch, there is continued amorous activity on the porch, and that's where Brandon stayed for the remainder of the evening. I know you're an intelligent woman. You know where we are right now. Where did Brandon tell you he was going to be tonight?
At the rodeo.
On his way to the rodeo, he picked up the same young lady that we've seen him with before.
So he's here now?
He's here now, and he's with this young lady. Are you sure this is something you want to continue with?
Yes.
All right, come on with me. Okay, where are we headed?
I'll each room. You have a detective inside, ready to let us go.
All right, come on, let's go.
They're over there by the blue machine. Go around the front.
Come on.
Oh my God.
What's going on? Oh,
what?
Damn.
Oh my. Who are you? Oh. Who are you?
Who are you?
What in the world? I'm his girlfriend.
Yeah. Bring this here.
Yeah.
Well, Brandon, were you going to say anything to her? Where would it have to happen?
Not here. It wasn't going to happen here, but not like this.
Well, how? I mean, it's not like you didn't have enough time.
It'd been something totally different than this right now.
You have a child.
Yeah, I do.
Right? There's 9 months there.
Yeah.
How long is this relationship going on?
A couple months.
A couple months. Okay. How much longer do you think it would have taken for you to tell your wife?
I don't know.
That you had a girlfriend.
Your son. Look at him.
You can't do this here.
What in the world? You got a family? What is this for?
No, I gotta go. Y'all can't do this here.
Where are you going? Where are you going?
Coming up, the conclusion.
On his way to the rodeo, he picked up the same young lady.
Oh my God.
Who are you?
I'm his girlfriend.
Where are you going? Brandon! Brandon! Talk to me.
I will, but we ain't gonna do it in there. That's ridiculous to bring all this out here.
You should have brought it to me. You shouldn't have brought it outside our family. Talk to me.
You had to bring it to the rodeo?
You shouldn't have been here. You should have been at home caring for your son and your wife.
We just go where the story takes us. And tonight, this is where it was.
Who is she? Who is she?
A friend. And I didn't mean for any of that to happen. It just did. And I'm sorry. But I don't know what else to say.
I mean, what led you into the arms of another woman?
We always have arguments and everything going on every now and then. And it just comes down to this.
Why are you going to do this?
The camera.
I don't understand.
I'm his wife.
And I never knew he was married.
He has a child, a 2-month-old child.
Sorry.
How did the two of you meet?
At a bar.
Man, get that thing out of here. Go. Get it. Y'all don't need to be here.
I didn't even know he was married. He doesn't wear a ring. We go out every other night, so I mean.
Where's your ring? Where's your ring? Where's the ring?
It's at the house.
You stood in front of God and everybody and said those vows.
Yes, I did.
They were forever, supposed to be forever.
They were, but.
Obviously not if you're sleeping with somebody else.
I think it's wise. That you know what the person that you're involved with
Right.
You know what they're capable of.
Of course. I'm glad I know that.
Never have time for me.
Okay.
You should be at home taking care of your son.
Wow.
Do you not love me? After all we've been through, you don't love me, and you're willing to go off and somebody else.
I did it one time, yes.
I don't think so.
One time.
That is so obviously a lie. You've been with me forever, like 6 months. We go out every night. Every phone call.
Every night?
Really?
So you're working and you're with her?
He's been with me every night for the last 6 months, or at least every other night.
There's been times that I have worked, and there's been times I've been with her too.
You're not the same person. Who are you?
You know, I don't need any of this, really. I don't.
No, but you made this happen.
I understand.
You brought this upon yourself, so for you to run out now
is
kind of cowardly.
That's fine. I'll take care of it as I go.
You figuring out as you go along isn't really going to help them any, and that's a big responsibility.
It is, but I'll take care of it as I go.
Unfortunately, the reason that we're here is because your wife loves you.
Look at these. Take them and look at them.
I know. I've seen these pictures.
You destroyed his life now.
No, I haven't.
You're not going to be a part of his life at all.
No, because you can't take that away from me.
I will.
It doesn't matter how much I messed up. You still can't take that away from me.
I will.
And I won't let you. So.
I will.
No, come on. Come on. Brandon?
Brandon.
Y'all need to get it. Y'all need to go.
Brandon.
That's enough. I've had enough of this stuff. You brought this here where I do.
You brought it.
Nope.
You brought it here.
We're not doing this. I'm not doing this.
You brought her here.
I'm not going to do this here. I'm not going to do it. Whatever.
Whatever. I love it. Whatever. You can bang me for 6 months and say whatever.
That is sad. And you walk out on your family?
Well, I need that hat back. I bought it.
Really?
Yeah.
Your camera.
Really? That's what I think about you.
Really, Brandon? You're not going to talk to me at all?
Ma'am, if you need a ride home, we'll make sure that you get there safely.
You're not man enough to talk to me? Or you don't have the balls to? You're scared now.
Man, y'all can get that thing and just go to hell with it. Really. I don't need y'all.
Okay. All right, you come with me. All right.
I'm out of here.
I want answers. I want answers now. Get out and talk to me. Brandon. Man up, Brandon. Man up.
Cowboy up, Brandon. Come on, man.
After the confrontation, Thelma is devastated by her husband's disastrous deeds. At the end of the show, we'll update you on her progress. But now, Paul, the suspect from the Neisha Lincoln case, comes in to unmask the true culprit of his troubles when caught with another woman on Cheers.
A couple of friends of mine, they all work together. We usually all go out for drinks. They just didn't happen to be there that time. You know, nothing was going on. It wasn't like I was cheating. The cheaters comes in with the cameras and all this, and it looked like, you know, with my girl, making it look like I've been doing something. Whatever, I might have been hugging on her a little bit. I was just going, you know, it was just drinks with a friend.
Oh, you and your bitch here? Is this what you are? Yes, I did. This is your bitch?
Nah. Supposed to have some drinks, you know what I'm saying?
No, I said you've been cheating on me. Yeah, you've been cheating. Yeah, you've been cheating. What you running for? What you running for in your Chicago Bears jacket that everybody sees you in?
The other chick is a dumb bitch, you know what I'm saying? She saw the cameras and started making up a bunch. It's all, you know, and cheaters, like I said, it's all camera tricks. I don't know what they showed her, but like I said, they pretty much drove her insane. Now I'm having problems with my girl because of whatever that you guys showed on camera that wasn't true. And I know regardless of what I say, they're going to try to make it look like I was doing something. I know I wasn't doing nothing.
So, ma'am, how long have you been with him?
we've been together for a while now, okay? I don't know what this is. I don't want to have any part of it.
They're trying to make me look bad.
Now, why would you want to
know?
I'm just not having drinks. This is all fake. This is all fake. This is all fake.
This is not fake.
Give me the camera. You want me to show you this girl? Come on.
What you running for?
Where are you running? Whoa. You all right?
Yeah, me and Nisha, we're going to work things out. And if we don't, then somebody else will come along. But I guarantee I won't be going through, you know, none of, I don't want to see you guys again. This is just a bunch of bull. Guys are all getting paid for whatever you're doing, and I'm getting...
Fighting through constant heartache, Thelma Gosling focuses her energy on her son and herself. Now that she knows the truth about her husband's treachery, Thelma has had a hard time getting the images out of her head. Thelma admits that she's at a crossroads and is waiting for guidance on where to turn. Admitting to the affair, Brandon Gosling claims to want his family back, but he admits it may not be all that simple. When questioned about Ms. Potts, Gosling claims to have had feelings for her. When contacted by Cheaters producers, Cassie Potts was adamant that she knew nothing about Thelma. When pressed on about the depth of their relationship, Potts revealed that she recently believed that she had gotten pregnant by Gosling. But
hey, please.
Buster!
Yeah, bitch, I'm gonna handcuff you.
Ladies. Get out of my face!
Oh my God!
You are a cheater.
Now you're a comedian.
That's what you deserve.
Real reality television, as brought to you by Cheaters Detective Agency's Private Eyes on Cheaters.
Uneasy about her husband's activities while supplementing his income, Lily Santiago seeks a truth she claims is veiled from her. Unable to trust those closest, Lily opens her relationship for an unbiased examination. I'm Joey Greco. And this is Cheaters.
Jesse was always telling me, I love you, hon, I'll be back. He was always communicating with me, letting me know every move that he was doing. He would call me to check up on me and the girls. And it's like lately he leaves, he won't even tell me where. When I do ask him, where have you been? It's like, what's it to you? He'll give me like nasty attitude. And I've noticed that when I ask him, let's go hang out like Thursdays was always our day. We'd either go to a movie or dinner. It was just him and I. And he just stopped doing that with me. He always comes up with, oh, I got plans. I got something going. I'm going to make extra hours. There was occasions where Jesse did ask me to go with him to the gigs, you know, and he would kind of show me off to his friends and say, this is my girl. Then it eventually just got to a point when I would ask him, can I go? He'd be like, well, you know, today's going to be a busy night. I won't have any attention. Again, it's like if I felt that I was bothering him for even asking him, can I go with you? If Jesse is cheating on me, I want him to realize that it's going to hurt more the family, that he needs to see that we love him, that we care for him. The girls always want him around. They're daddy's little girls, and he needs to start realizing what he has at home.
If you suspect infidelity in your relationship, Cheaters Detective Agency may be able to provide you assistance. Exercise your right to be informed. Investigative charges may apply. Jesse Santiago, age 37, a DJ accused of enjoying a mashup between himself and another woman. Investigation Day 1. Agents set up a perimeter around the suspect's day job, which is managing a printing lab. Upon closing up shop for the day, agents catch sight of the suspect, Jesse Santiago, exiting the building and entering his convertible sports car. He is followed down the highway for quite some time before finally coming to rest at a local Mexican cantina. He departs from his vehicle and is instantly engulfed in the arms of an unknown female. The two seem quite happy to see each other. They hug and kiss before walking arm in arm into the restaurant. The couple grab a table, sitting side by side. As the hot sauce flows, so does the affection between Santiago and his mystery woman. The couple clink bottles and enjoy their meal. Over an hour passes before the couple exit the restaurant. They hold each other close as they walk through the parking lot. Santiago sees his consort safely into her car and then follows her to her residence. They ascend the stairs to the companion's apartment and disappear inside for quite some time. Eventually, agents regain a line of sight on the suspect as he gets into his car and returns home to his uneasy wife. Investigation Day 4. After quite a few days with little movement on the case, agents catch a break. They receive a call from Lily stating her husband's claims of needing to work late. Agents spot Santiago leaving the lab and darting off in his automobile. He rushes to the other side of town and enters a well-respected record shop. Inside, waiting for his arrival, is his companion from previous surveillance, Mary Castillo. Ground agents capture Santiago and his mistress's enthusiasm for each other as they inspect the shop's rare collections. When Castillo moves over to browse the import section, Santiago starts to browse her behind. The two finally exit the establishment and share a kiss while walking through the darkened parking lot. Ever the gentleman, Santiago sees his querida into her car. Mobile units continue tracking their suspect as he again meets Castillo outside a nearby restaurant. It is quite evident from the couple's behavior that they are well versed in one another's intimate areas. After dinner, the two return to Castillo's home. Santiago spends much of the night inside before finally pulling himself away and returning home only hours before dawn. Investigation Day 5. For a second day in a row, the suspect recycles his excuse of having to work late. Unbeknownst to him, however, Lily has professional eyes glued to his every move. Mobile units follow Santiago to Castillo's apartment complex. It appears to be a real date this time, as Santiago ushers his lady love from her apartment and into his car. With the top down, a canopy of stars twinkle brightly, helping the suspect add to the romance in the air. They soon arrive at a quite pricey tapas bar. They enter and begin to enjoy each other's lips as appetizers. However, it's Lily who's hungry for answers, evident in this recorded phone call with her husband.
Hello?
Hey, man.
What's up,
man? It's my little boy. Are you okay?
I'm good.
What's up? Where are you?
Working.
Well, I know that, but, like, what time are you coming home? You're taking forever.
What'd you say? I can't hear you. What?
Serious? Okay, what time are you coming home, Fred?
Why do you do this every time I have a job?
Jesse, I'm just asking. I mean, honey, come on. You're hardly ever at home. You know, I sometimes miss your voice.
All right, look, bottom line. You love me?
With all the evidence they need, Cheater's agents close the case and begin assembling the disturbing details for Lily's inspection. Coming up, the confrontation.
With a mountain of evidence piling up, Lily's contacted to inspect the findings. As anxiety courses through her, she pulls herself together long enough to discover the truth.
Now, I know that there have been some things that have gone on in your relationship with Jesse that have caused you some suspicion and concern. I think our detectives have information that may put your mind at ease. Are you ready to take a look at that now? On this particular day, Jesse left work, gets into his car, and our detectives followed him until he arrived at a restaurant. A short time later, a car pulls up alongside, greets a young lady, and they go into the restaurant.
I know who she is.
You know this woman?
I've seen her at the club with Jesse by the booth. I don't know her, but I know I've seen her.
Now, is this the one that you've already expressed?
Yes.
That there was some peculiar dynamic that was taking place whenever you were there together with Jesse. They go into the restaurant. We can see the two of them engaged in conversation. They walk out to the vehicles together. He puts her in her vehicle. He bends in. And it looks like he gives her a quick kiss. But from there, they follow one another to what we believe to be her residence. He's inside for some time. And when he exits, we notice that he's adjusting his shirt. And from there, he goes home. On this evening, Lily, Jesse leaves work and goes directly to this young lady's apartment. He goes inside, collects her. They come out, travel to a restaurant. As they're walking in, we observe the holding of hands. And now we can see clearly that this is a romantic evening. After dinner, they go outside, share a few more tender moments before going back to the residence of this woman. And again, later that night, Jesse exits the building and leaves. Lily, I know that while you suspected something was going on, it's never any easier when you confirm it. If you still have the desire, we can provide you with an opportunity to confront Jesse.
Yes, please. I have to have... Oh, yes, yes, Joey. I would want to see where that son of a bitch is. Where is that... Oh, where is he? Where is he right now?
He went to work, and as soon as he got there, the same young lady that you suspected and that we've seen him with arrived. And we know that's where they are now.
Okay. I want to go. I want to see where he's at. I want to see where he's at.
Okay, come with me. We'll go in the van. We'll call the detective from there, okay?
Okay.
Yeah, we're wrapped up and we're in the vans moving in your direction. All right, sounds good. Okay, hey, let everybody know he's wearing black. She's wearing a flowered dress. Okay. Still, you see us?
Yep.
All right, yeah, I see you now. Gotcha. All right. Okay, they're on the back patio.
Serious?
All right, here we are.
Everybody out. Everybody out. Everybody out.
Okay, let's see if we can figure out. Go ahead, go.
Coming up next, the conclusion.
Oh, where is he? Where is he right now?
He went to work, and as soon as he got there, the same young lady arrived.
You don't need it. You got
Watch out.
Come on.
Watch out. Watch out. Watch out.
I can't believe you would do this. I can't believe you would do this.
How you gonna hit her?
You know what, huh? That's your kids, man.
How you gonna
kid? That is your kids. That's your kids. That is your kids, man. Okay, can't you go to your girls and tell them what the you're doing? Your two daughters, man. Your two daughters, bitch.
That's my silver.
Right, right. It's you over. Yeah, you're most definitely. You can keep this, bitch.
Right,
but you know what? Your daughters will see this. That's right. I'll see you in court, bitch. I'll see you. Whatever, I'll see you in court, you man.
Let's get out of here.
Stand right there, come on. Stand right there.
Following the confrontation, Lily is left battered and bruised both physically and emotionally. Stay tuned when we reveal how she's recovering. But now, Cheaters welcomes Q, the entertainer from the Faye Weathers case. Q hopes to present her version of events when confronted on Cheaters.
You come into a business like this, I expect the worst at all times. It just kind of caught me off guard with, you know, how we had been carrying on for that amount of time, and nothing had even gave me a reason to think that there was another woman involved. So, I mean, it was a shock to me, and, you know, in the type of business and field that I'm in, it kind of just kind of made me feel a little uncomfortable, you know, being that me and him had were getting to that level of just, you know, casually, you know, getting to know each other a lot better and outside of what I do for my business.
No, what the f- you're my ass.
Who are you?
No, no.
Who are you?
No, no, who the f- you?
I'm doing
no,
my
no,
thing.
Who
No,
who the you? No, I want to know who the you are.
Yeah,
but
I got paid.
She was really outraged and just, you know, really dramatic. So I'm pretty sure, you know, they probably had an altercation. But from that point, I just tried to get myself out of the situation and, you know, try to at least be calm and explain to her, you know, look, this is what I do. This is my business. Darren's a cool guy, but I don't even know you. I never even heard about you.
Don't put your hands on me! You need to get your man together, sweetie. This is what I do for a living.
Get out of my house. You want to play with me? 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 You want to cheat on me? Mitch, get out of my house.
Don't
right now. My plane on. Don't get you.
Yes,
I,
no.
I know
if
one thing.
You
no, you want to go to my house?
Sweetie.
No, bitch, you want to be. You want to play? You want to play with me? You want to play with me?
Once again, if he contacts me, wants to see me again, it's definitely, you know, a possibility. It definitely can happen still. I don't have any hard feelings toward Thurm. I think that, you know, he really wants to be done with her, and she's just a psychotic, dramatic woman who is afraid to let him go.
Following the hard-fought confrontation, Lily Santiago spent most of her night boxing up her husband's belongings and placing them by the curb. Lily is currently seeking a divorce, including full custody of their two daughters. According to Jesse Santiago, his marriage to Lily was over a long time ago, and her desperate attempt at sabotage will backfire. He goes on to say that despite the chaos of the confrontation, he and his companion are better than ever. Mary